Aloha. Welcome to this YouTube channel. I used to call this channel as Koroa Jodo Mission YouTube channel. However, I never get approval from Koroa Jodo Mission, so this is not an official YouTube channel of Koroa Jodo Mission, but this is my very personal YouTube account. And so right now I'm using my name, Kosen Ishikawa, the channel name, but in the near future, I'm thinking to change the name so that maybe I'm hoping more people could come to this channel. And what I want to do is here is to provide more information, good information, useful information, as many as possible. And in Japan, if you are interested in Jodo Buddhism, Jodo Shu, there are many great books you could get. Excellent books, all the information is available if you can interested in that. However, here in the United States, English information is very limited. So what I want to do is that I want to provide more, you know, good information. Actually, I hope, you know, the information I provide is good, but whether it's good or bad, I want to do more information. And so that doesn't restrict to Jodo Buddhism, but I want to provide more, you know, different kind of information and useful information. That's my hope. Last time, and so this is actually the part 7 of the lecture on Ichimaiki Shomon, or one sheet document. And last time, what I really wanted to say was that, you know, there is a, you know, beautiful translation, and there is an exact translation, and there is an interesting translation, and there could be many types of translations, and all the translators want to translate beautifully. And it sounds beautifully, it looks beautifully, what we want to do. However, beautiful translation is not always to be exact. That I really wanted to say. For example, that the translation of Sanjin is that three hearts or three minds, and translator thinks that. Shijou Shin, Jin Shin, Eko Hotsugan Shin. Shin, 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 right? And it sounds very comfortable and beautiful. So the translator, what he or she thinks of first is that continue the sound beautiful. So if you translate shin as heart, then what is beautiful is that, you know, heart, heart, heart is beautiful. Or if you set the word as mind, then mind, mind, mind is beautiful. Or if you translate shin as thought, 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 thought is beautiful. That I really wanted to say. But if, you know, we don't need to be stick, we don't need to stick to beautiful, we can do exact translation. Like we can examine what is the meaning. So by deep examination of the its meaning, if we don't stick to the beautiful translations, we can have exact translation. And that could be like the Shijou Shin is sincere heart or genuine heart, and Jin Shin is profound mind, and Eko Hotsugan Shin is a mind, the desire. So depending on which, you know, the word, and if we don't stick to a beautiful translation, we could have exact translation. However, the most important thing is that the more translation, the better we could have understanding, could be better. So to have various translation is actually wonderful. And you know, if just imagine that if everybody translate in the same way, in the same manner, in the same sentence, And that translation is not interesting. It seems that very boring because everybody is different, right? However, everybody translate in the same way is not interesting. Because you are different, I'm different. We could have different understanding and we have different translation. That is really good. So the fact that more translation, the better and the deeper, maybe the deeper we could have understanding. That's why I want to understand Ichimaeki Shomo in my understanding. Before talking about the next sentence, I'd like to introduce the great teaching of Honen Shonin I found recently. And this was so interesting. Nowadays, I'm reading Wago Toroku, the collective works of Honen Shonin, the collective saying of and the writing letters of Honen Shonin. And this is so interesting. And one of another resource is that Shoko Shonin Gopo, this is the words of Bencho, the second founder of Jodo-shu, Bencho, and his collective sayings and works is here. And these are gifts from Dharma friend Stefan in Saga Prefecture in Japan. Thank you so much. And he sent me this several years ago, but now I'm reading this, the works of Bencho, Shoko Shonin, and I'm really enjoying this book because this is filled with Bencho's understanding of the Master Honen Shonin. And Master Honen had, many disciples, many leading disciples. And in Wago Toroku, there is a chapter called Shonin Denzetsu no Kotoba. Shonin Denzetsu no Kotoba is that the six leading disciples, has received. They received the teaching from Master Honen. And this is not sure, historically not sure it's correct or not, but it is said that they received the teaching from Master Honen. And this Shonin Denzetsu no Kotoba and so there are some teaching that second founder Bencho or Shoko Shonin received directly from Honen Shonin. That part is so interesting. And the second founder Shoko Shonin or Bencho, this is a mainstream of Jodo-shu. So the understanding of Bencho or Shoko Shonin is leading. What is Jodo-shu? What is the right understanding of Jodo-shu? So in that sense, his understanding of Honen Shonin was so interesting. And anyway, the chapter Shonin Densetsu no Kotoba, and there is a title and there is a short sentence that, and this saying was very interesting, and this is, I think, the essence of Honen Shonin. And I was so excited because I found, before, actually, I have read this sentence, but at that time, I didn't realize the importance of that short sentence. But now, for me, very clear that this is the very essence of the Honen Shonin. And let me read it. So the chapter is that Shonin Densetsu no Kotoba, and the title is Ichijou no Hori. Ichijou no Hori is a moat which is about 3.3 meter wide. And 3.3 meter is about 10 feet wide moat. So it's about moat. Why moat? Let me read it. Ichijou no Hori. また人ごとに商人常にのたまいしは一条の堀を越えんと思わん人は一条五尺を越えんと励むべし。Yeah, so this one in the beginning part of this sentence, it clearly stated that 商人常にのたまいしは that means that 法然商人 was always saying, you know, to the person to person. That is the beginning part. 法然上人 Master 法然 was always saying, person to person. So, that means, you know, always indicate that this is a great teaching, very important part. And so, let me read in modern Japanese. また、人ごとに商人が常におっしゃっておられたのは、一条ある堀を越えんと思う人は、一条五尺を越えんと励みなさい。And, you know, fortunately, we do have the great translation of 和語登録 by Bishop Atone and Mrs. Yoko Hayashi, Mrs. Horiuchi. They did great job, and this is a precious gift. You know, it's for somebody's translation, it's easy to say, you know, this is right or wrong, you know, it's easy to criticize, but to do translation, you know, is very difficult, and it takes time and energies, and not only energy, but also patience, so they need it. So this is such a great gift from Bishop Atone and Mrs. Horiuchi, and thank you so much. And this is a great light in the future. And this is a great translation. So I don't need to translate this, you know, in English because we already have. So this is it's written on Shonin Denzetsu no Kotoba. So page 312. Okay. 法然上人 often said, "One who plans to jump over a moat 10 feet wide." Must make every effort to jump 15 feet. One more time. 法然上人 often said, "One who plans to jump over a moat 10 feet wide must make every effort to jump 15 feet." So, this sentence, the goal is to jump over the moat. So, 10 feet. So, 10 feet wide moat. Is a goal. This is goal. Okay. If you have this goal, you have to make every effort to cross 15 feet. Sorry. I'm very excited. This is very interesting teaching. 15 feet more. So, this is goal and this is means.So this is way. This is what we call practice. And the person who plans to jump over 10 feet wide moat, you know, he should not practice to jump over 10 feet wide, but he should make efforts higher goal. So this indicates that You should set a goal, higher goal. It's very important. And this, in English, there is a word that to shoot for stars, to shoot for a star, or to shoot for moon. And the expression to shoot for star, as you know, means that to set a high goal. So, to shoot for moon, by shooting higher place, you know, by having such a higher goal, and you try to do the higher goal, without knowing it, you can achieve easily what you wanted to do. You can get close the easy job by having such a high goal.So this is actually the 一条の堀を越えんと思わん人は is exactly saying that to shoot for a star, to shoot for a moon. So this is a great teaching that still living in modern world. And this is very true, this sentence.The saying is very true. And You know, I was amazed by the professor Shinya Yamanaka, who won the Nobel Prize Award. Yeah, Nobel Prize. He says that when he was a student, he was so told that, you know, to shoot for a moon, and that led him to study more about, you know, science, you know, medical, and to find the iPS cell. And iPS cell is a very excellent cell that could good for any part of the body, potentially. And he won the Nobel Award. And so to shoot for a star is good for the teaching, still living in the today. And 法然上人 always saying this. 常にのたまえしは法然上人 was often said. 法然上人 often said in this translation, but was always saying. And this indicates two parts, right? So one, to set a high goal.And second part, this is such a short sentence, but the essence is condensed in the sentence. And so what is the second part is? Make efforts. Make every effort to achieve the higher goal. So to have a higher goal means what?Does it mean to have a higher goal? So, this is I understand, this is what we call Anjin. Anjin is faith. So, to set a goal, 一条を超えんと思わん人は means to jump, the one who plan to jump over the 10 feet wide moat means faith. The, what is your goal? What is your goal? And 法然上人 says that to have a higher goal. This is the faith. And by having the goal, you know, which way you go, by having a goal, you can haveThe feeling of assurance. You can have assurance. You know, you can have the feeling of easy and relax and assurance. That we call Anjin, the faith. And not only Anjin, but 法然上人that to have a, you know, higher goal, then you should practice. You should make every effortTo achieve this goal, try to achieve the goal. So make efforts is what we call Hiyo. This is practice. So this is such a short sentence, but this can be divided into the faith. Have faith, okay? And then make efforts. And this explains, you know, how many times.Should we name to, and this is it. This is it. If you can have your own goal, and but if you have your own goal, you can set higher, like 10 times name to. Maybe you should make efforts to try to say 20 times. And if you set a time 1,000 times, maybe you should make efforts to try to do.2,000 times. So this number doesn't matter. Number doesn't matter. But at least your attitude, your modes, that is to 一条五尺を超えんと励むべし。励むべし is a, you know, exercise. Make efforts. This is the great teaching of 法然上人.I found, so I'm very excited, and oh, you know, this one, 人ごとに上人常にのたまえしは、法然上人 often said, and 法然上人 was always saying this, person to person. So this is a proof that the teaching is very important. And because the second founder, Benna Shoko Shonin, Bencho, received this teaching. So this was transmitted to second founder, Bencho Shoko Shonin. And also, it follows that 王女五千人は欠場の信を取りて愛励むべきなり緩くしては可能べからず You know, do not be lazy. If you are lazy, you cannot achieve it. Make efforts. So make efforts is very important. And so, let me read in modern Japanese. 王女をしたいと誓っている人は信心を確固たるものとして励むべきです。気を緩めてはいけません。Okay, don't be loose. Don't be lazy. Make efforts. Okay, 信心を確固たるものとして励むべきです。And there is a now very convenient. We do have English translation that 和語登録 And by reading in different languages, for me, it's getting clear and clear.Okay, next part in the same manner, one who aspires to birth in the pure land must establish decisive faith in the certain attainment of birth in the pure land. Birth in the pure land will become impossible if one loosens this belief. If one loosens this belief, that means you make efforts. You should make efforts. And the next part.Is actually very interesting because there is 一枚起承文。一枚起承文 is actually transmitted to 聖観坊現地承人 the day, 2 days before Master passed away. You know, January 23rd, 1212, that Master Honen. However, according to the legend, the second founder, Bencho, 聖光承人Receive the same teaching, the 一枚起承文 from Master Honen, and it's written in other, you know, teaching that received from Master to Bencho, second founder. And this 一枚起承文 is more in detail as compared to the 一枚起承文 transmitted to 現地 what we are now reading. And should I say this or later? But I want to say that is the first sentence, if you remember, the second, the 聖観坊現地承人 transmitted, received, but it start with no subject, right? No subject, and it started from もろこし和歌城にもろもろの使者たちのさだし申される観念の念にもあらず and no subject and I said that because the relationship of Master Honen and 聖観坊現地 was so close so Master, for Master Honen he didn't need to say the subject of the sentence because so close it was omitted.But this one, the 一枚起承文 which was transmitted to the second founder, 聖光上人 the subject is written, subject is clearly written, and that one, yeah, let me say this. また上人ののたまわく、念仏往生と申すことは、this is the subject, 念仏往生と申すことは、what is called 念仏? What is called 往生?This is the subject of the 一枚起承文法然承認 according to the second founder, Bencho. And it, the subject is written. So, in the beginning part, 念仏往生と申すことは the subject is what is called 念仏 What is called 往生?もろこし我が町のもろもろの知者たちのさたし申される観念の念仏にもあらず So in the,、trans, in the 一枚起承文 that was transmitted to 聖観坊現地 that is only 観念の念にもあらず But over here it's written 観念の念仏にもあらず。 And next part、 また学問をして念仏の心を悟りて通して申す念仏にもあらず。 So this part a little different, like また学問をして and the 一枚木正門 which was transmitted to second founder 現地、また学問をして念の心を悟りて申す。 But over here、 また学問をして念仏の心を悟りて通して申す念仏にもあらず。ただ極楽に往生せんがために南無阿弥陀仏と申して疑いなく往生するぞと思い取りて申す他に別のことなし。 So in 一枚木正門聖観法現地 is 別の司祭そうらわず。 But over here more simple、 申す他に別のことなし。ただし三人像四種像何度と申すことの候は皆南無阿弥陀仏は欠場して往生するぞと思ううちに収まれる。 And the one we are reading is 思ううちに、こもり候なる。 And ただ南無阿弥陀仏と申せば欠場して往生することなりと信じ取るべきなる。 And this actually 一枚木正門、What is a big difference is that the subject is written, and another big difference is that there is no words of preach, there is no words of bow. So this is actually 法然上人 already transmitted to Bencho, but at his death, at his death moment, 法然上人 added 起承門 the strong bow, by adding strong bow,His words more straight, more powerful. So that is a big difference. And next part. 念仏を信ぜん人は、たとえ一代の実りをよくよく学し、極めたる人なりとも、文字一つも知らぬ、愚痴鈍根の不覚の身になして、天入道の無知の友柄に、我が身を同じくなして、知者振る舞いせずして、ただ一向に南無阿弥陀仏と申してぞ、叶わんずると。 So this part was transmitted to the second founder 弁長証拠証人 and the difference. So over here is the promise of Amida Buddha page 312 and so the 法然上人 also stated regarding birth in the pure land through 念仏. So this is the subject. Soof 一枚木正門。 So over here it's written but you know the 一枚木正門 which was transmitted to second 観法現地上人 was no subject was written. That is a huge difference of the. So later after reading you know the 一枚木正門 which we usually read maybe we should examine, we should see, check, you know, the 弁長上人 一枚木正門 so later. So that means that this series will continue more, some more. And after that, I want to see the words of 証拠上人 the second founder, 証拠上人 that is,Very interesting. Because you know, you already know 一条の堀 the person who plans to jump over 10 feet wide moat should make every effort to jump over 15 wide moat. So to, that is to shoot for stars. Okay, everybody, especially children, to set a higher goal. Go for it, go for it, go forward.By going and making efforts, there is a way. So one more time, when there is a will and there is a goal, there is a way. So I want to encourage, you know, not only 浄土宗 people, but also all the children. You know, children has dream. They have dreams. And I want them to achieve their dreams. And how?They can achieve their dreams. That is to shoot for stars. 一条の堀を越えんと思わん人は一条五尺の堀を越えんと励むべし。That is the teaching that our Master Honen Shonin said. So, generally, Buddhism can be divided in two parts. That is the teaching, how to live, how to be happy, like how to change your bad condition to be better one, how to understand this world, and how to understand yourself from negative thoughts to positive thoughts. That is the one great teaching. I mean, the great one side of the great teachings of Buddhism. And another part is that after this, where are we going? Where are we going? You know, this is maybe the if you know how to live in this life is in the beginning part of our life. Maybe the last part of the life is also important, because as we get older and older, we get sickness, we get near to the death, we get fear, worries, many bad thoughts might come. But by having the goal, where are we going? You know, we can have assurance, at least assurance. And this is another part that Buddhism is trying to teach. How to live in this life, how to be happy. At the same time, as we realize that this moment is very precious and we might die, you know, at the next moment. We don't know. This world, you know, we don't know. We could die at the next moment. And it did happen, actually, March 11, 2011, that many people, all of a sudden, it happened. Earthquake, the huge earthquake happened, followed by tsunami. And many people didn't think that they would die in the next moment, but actually happened. This is a life that, from the viewpoint of universe, anything could happen, and we are actually not sure. So what we can do? That Buddhism teaches that. How we can do? What we can do? How we can be happy? This is the present moment. What we can do is very limited. That, okay, this is true that we can die anytime, but we don't need to worry because the future has never arrived. We don't need to worry about future, but this present moment we surely have. We surely have this present moment. Okay, we enjoy the moment. We cherish the moment. Okay, if we realize this, the importance of present moment, fighting, war, envy, jealousy, so stupid, so ridiculous that we have only present moment. We should cherish the present moment. That is a great teaching of Buddhism. At the same time, where are we going? Are we going to heaven? Are we going to Pure Land? We need to set a goal. By having a goal, we can have great assurance. So that is two part, and our Jodo Shu teaches both present moment and the next life. Okay. Ikeraba nembutsu no kou tsumori, shinaba jodo ni mairina. Okay, now going back to Ichimaiki Shomon, Wangshi document, and previously Honen Shonin said everything. And he said that if it's not true, you know, I would not be received the compassions of Amida Buddha and Shakyamuni Buddha. And he strongly made a vow that if it's not true, you know, what he said was not true, then he would not be born into the Pure Land of Amida Buddha. So this is the strongest vow that he made, that he showed everything, and he didn't hide any teaching, and the teaching is very simple, it's true. And because Honen Shonin was so sure, you know, that's more than confidence, he was sure that's true. So that's why he made a vow, he made a pledge, a strong pledge, that he is not, you know, if it's he's telling a lie. If it's not true, then I would not be born into the pure land. So, that one is what we call kishomon or the bow. And the next sentence is more clear because it says that there is a subject and also what we should do. Subject and what we should is very clear in the next sentence. And the next sentence is the conclusion. The conclusion of Ichimai Kishomon. What Onen Shonin said last. This is the last teaching of Onen Shonin. So let's see. First, I want to read it. So, 念仏を信ぜん人は、たとえ一代の法をよくよく学すとも、一文淵の愚鈍の身になして、天入道の無知の友柄に同じうして、知者の振る舞いをせずして、ただ一向に念仏すべし。So, this is such a long sentence. But to understand this sentence, what is subject? The subject is 念仏を信ぜん人は、念仏 is a 念仏。And to recite name Namu Amida Butsu, that's 念仏。信ぜん人は is 人 means person. The person who does believe in 念仏。And so 信ぜん人は is who is going to believe, who is going to believe 念仏。That is the meaning. Who does believe in 念仏。So the person who does believe in 念仏、念仏を信ぜん人は、so the person is the subject, and the person could be man, could be woman, you know, could be noble, could be poor, could be anybody. It is the person, 人は。And what kind of person? The subject clearly says that the person who does believe in 念仏。And what is the conclusion? The verb. Verb comes in the end. That is, ただ一向に念仏すべし。ただ一向に念仏すべし is his conclusion. So the person who does believe in 念仏, ただ, you know, just 一向に is a, you know, 一向に is one face, facing one. And this means thatYou know, devoutly or single-heartedly, single-mindedly, so concentration to one thing. So, ただ一向に single-mindedly, 念仏すべし。すべし means you should do that. You know, the person who does believe in 念仏 should recite 念仏。念仏すべし。You know, do 念仏 single mindedly. ただ一向に念仏すべし。 So the conclusion is very simple. That is to recite 南無阿弥陀仏 single mindedly. And so the between the subject and verb, that what kind of, you know, attitude is telling that. So 念仏を信ぜん人はたとえ一代の方をよくよく学すとも means たとえ is even though. So even though 一代の方 is actually 釈迦牟尼 Buddha is omitted. So 一代の方 means 一代 is one life, lifetime of 釈迦牟尼 Buddha. So 釈迦牟尼 Buddha is omitted, but 一代の方 is the lifetime of teaching of 釈迦牟尼 Buddha. So even though and Gakustomo. Gakustomo is to study. Nowadays, we call it manabu, but it, over here it says gakusu. Gakusu is to study. So even though you study, you know, the entire teachings, the whole life teaching of Shakyamuni Buddha, even though you know, you studied well. Yoku yoku, yoku yoku, yoku is well. So well, well.And yoku yoku means thoroughly or completely. So even if you study completely and thoroughly the teachings, the entire teaching of Shakyamuni Buddha, that is the attitude. And 一代の方をよくよく学すとも、and next part is 一文不知の愚鈍の身になして、一文不知 and 一文 means penny and 不知 means don't know. So that 一文不知 literally means that he doesn't know even the penny, even the penny. So 一文不知 means doesn't know anything.Doesn't know anything, so doesn't know, literally doesn't know penny, the worth of penny. So it means that doesn't know anything. 一文不知の愚鈍の身になして。And 愚鈍, 愚 means, you know, stupid. 愚 is 愚か, the stupid. And 鈍 means dull or slow, the slow mind, you know.To calculate slow, we call 鈍い That is don. So sometimes we call, because 法然上人 said himself that 重悪の法然 I'm very sinful, you know, and I'm very stupid, idiot. So that is 重悪の法然愚痴の法然坊 So 愚鈍の身愚鈍 is exactly like 愚痴 So 愚鈍 means the stupid, idiot and the realization of idiot we call 愚鈍の身になして So even though you study you know, the entire teaching of Shakyamuni Buddha thoroughly and completely But you realize that you are stupid, idiot. And what does it mean? This is, sounds like, you know, the completely opposite of common sense. That common sense usually that be wise, right? Be wise and you get something very important. So try to be wise. But the teaching of 法然上人 is,Try to be stupid. Try to be idiot. And what does it tell? And this is the very important part of 法然上人. Satuan, 法然上人 was said that, you know, the number one scholar, he could be the number one scholar in Japan. And his knowledge is so vast. And he was absolutely the outstanding scholar at that time. AndHe studied a lot, you know, in the beginning part of his life, until 42 years old, 43 years old, he studied. And he was known as a scholar already. But he said that, what he said that, even though you study well, you know, you should be realized. You should realize that you are stupid. AndThis is very profound because the common sense are be wise, but Hone Shonin said that be stupid means a lot. Like, this is like returning to the starting point. By realizing that we don't know, we could be improved. And if you realize that you know everything,Oh, okay, the realization of I know, the realization of, you know, I know everything, is, that means no improvement. Because he realized that he knows everything, right? So there could be no improvement. And that means if you know everything, that you can refuse some other people saying, oh, I know this, I don't know, I don't need to listen.Okay, I know, I know. Yeah, I know, I know. Some people, you know, sometimes before talking, oh, okay, I know, I know. And actually, that attitude, 法然上人 said, no, do not be wise. But suppose if you truly realize that you don't know, okay, I'm very stupid, I'm very ignorant, This is a starting point. If you realize that, truly realize that I don't know, that I could know more, okay? Because I don't know, I want to hear next, okay? Oh, thank you. This is something I didn't know. That by realizing, returning to the stupidity or idiot, we could improve. The Ho Nen Shonin was saying like this. Ho Nen Shonin, return to the stupid. No, the realization of stupid is very important. By having that, you know, realization, we could improve a lot. And this actually means that sometimes Ho Nen Shonin is very humble man, was very humble man, known as a humble man, the person of modesty. But this came from, that realization actually came from his wisdom. That is a wisdom that came from the Greek philosophy, that Socrates. I always remember, whenever hear, you know, たとえ一代の方をよくよく学すとも、一文淵の愚鈍の身になして、アマニュードの無知の友柄に同じをして、知者の振る舞いをせずして。And this always reminds me that the words of Socrates that we call 無知の知。That 知 wisdom。Wisdom of ignorance. Wisdom of ignorance. The person who realizes that ignorant is wise. The wisdom. The person who has wisdom is ignorant. And this is actually, we tend to think, oh, this is maybe modest, you know, humble expression, but that's not, no. The person who knows the best is the person who doesn't know. Because, so this is the expression that the Socrates, so that was Socrates is came from the words of Plato, yeah? So that is the wise man, is she who knows she doesn't know. So the wisest is she who knows that she doesn't know. So that is the expression that the wisdom of ignorance. But this means that, you know, the person who knows, who doesn't know, this is complicated, but, you know, the person, the wise person is somebody, is she, who knows she doesn't know, is actually she knows a lot. Because she knows a lot, she can say that, the person who doesn't know. Because to know something, to know, is actually divide what you know and what you don't know. So, to know something is actually you understand what you know and exactly what you don't know. And the more knowledge you learn, at the same time that the more knowledge that we don't know, the more study means the more the knowledge that we don't know. So who is the wise man? Who can be the most knowledgeable man? Is that the most knowledgeable man was something that who knows she doesn't know, the wisdom of ignorance. That is the same teaching that Ho Nen Shonin told. You know, there is nothing to do with Greek philosophy, you know, Western culture, Western studies, but Ho Nen Shonin, because he was a wise man, so he probably studied, you know, and the ultimate wisdom is that I don't know. I know at the same time I don't know. That is the ultimate, you know, the sense of wisdom. That 法然上人 achieve, that is, you know, it also, there is a quote that Albert Einstein, you know, Albert Einstein, there is a word that, you know, the more I study, the more I realize how much I don't know. This one, I'm not sure, Mr., you know, Dr. Einstein really said, but I'm not sure, but it is said that the more he said, the more I study, the more I realize how much I don't know. This is the same meaning, that the wisdom of ignorance. And 法然上人 was truly realizes, and he left the world. So, 念仏を信ぜん人は、たとえ一代の方をよくよく学すとも、you know, even though you thoroughly and completely study,The entire teaching of Shakyamuni Buddha, the lifetime, you know, 一文不知の is, you know, the person who don't know, anything, 愚鈍の身になして、okay, you realize the stupid, truly stupid, 阿摩入道の無知の共柄に同じようして、so this is another expression of, you know, to realize that ignorance, andOver here he says that 阿摩入道の無知の共柄に同じをして That 阿摩 is means none and 入道 means the person who entered the Buddhahood the person who started training of Buddhism that we call 入道 and 入道 literally means that you know the person who entered the road.Who enter the road, so that new door. And this actually indicates that I didn't know, but I read something about, you know, 法然上人 age. 阿摩入道 was very common. And that means that, you know, the person who looks monk, who looked monk, but who was actually not monk, is there were many people over there.So that 阿摩入道 is representation that, you know, they look like priest. They look like priest and priestess, right? 阿摩 is a nun and priestess. And 入道 is a person who shave his head or he shave her head and look like a monk. But what they do was not.A priest. That is, so there were many kind of, you know, looking Buddha, but so that one, 阿摩入道の無知の共柄に同じをして and so realize that, you know, and that was considered to be gudon or guji, the stupid. So you are same, you know, even though you study thoroughly about your scholar, even though you are a wise man, but be realize that you are not so different from 阿摩入道. You know, you are not so different from, you know, stupid people. You are not different from 阿摩入道. And 智者の振る舞いをせずして is do not pretend wise. Do not pretend to be scholar. Do not pretend to be wise.That is very important. So, you know, even though you know, but by returning to the original point and recite Namo Amida Butsu. Because if you single-mindedly recite Namo Amida Butsu, 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 how much you know things, how much you know studies, you know, how much you are wise, how much you have money,You know, how much, how you are old, you are young, it doesn't matter, everybody say. By the attitude of reciting Namo Amida Butsu, you know, noble or poor, man or woman, rich or poor, it doesn't matter. Everybody can become one toward Amida Buddha. by reciting Namo Amida, Namo Amida, Namo Amida, Namo Amida. You know, it doesn't matter. So that one, 法然上人 said. And the subject is that if you do believe in 念仏, if you are going to believe in 念仏, you should recite Namo Amida Butsu single-mindedly. And, you know, it doesn't matter when, you know, how much you study, how much you are smart, it doesn't matter how much you are rich, how much you are noble, how much you are poor, it doesn't matter. You know, you should realize that we are not different, no different in the attitude of reciting Namo Amida Butsu. And so this is the conclusion of 一枚起承文。念仏を信ぜん人はたとえ一代の法をよくよく学すとも一文淵の愚鈍の身なして天入道の無知の友柄に同じゅうして知者の振る舞いをせずしてただ一向に念仏すべし。So 法然上人's thoughts. What is 法然上人's thought is selection.You know, he followed Master Doshak and Master Shantao. That is the key word is selection. To divide easy and difficult, noble and pure, you know, that kind of selection. And 法然上人 was able to find the selection in everything. So that's why his sayings is like, you know, as for...The 念仏往生 As for the birth in the pure land, and over here, as for the person who does believe in 念仏 so he kind of, he offered, he present, you know, he present, there could be many choices, there could be some choices, but My teaching is, you know, he present some choices, like attaining samadhi, you know, like 別寺念仏, very special 念仏, everyday 念仏, and 臨終念仏, is a, you know, near death 念仏, everyday 念仏, so he divide. So he present some choices, but he chose, okay, as for the birth in the 念仏, so my teaching isThere could be many teaching, right? Many great teaching. But my teaching and what I want to talk about is he chose the selection that I, as for the birth in the pure land of Amida Buddha. Okay? And I put aside other teaching. And as for, you know, if you believe in 念仏, you can just recite 念仏.And that is the stance, the very basic stance and the great stance that 法然上人 took. So we have to read it very correctly. 法然上人 present many possibilities and choices us. But as for myself, that as for 法然上人, he chose that 法然上人. So, that is the thought.法然 our master, 法然上人 And his great, teaching is here in 一枚起承文。念仏を信ぜん人は、たとえ一代の法をよくよく学すとも、一文淵の愚鈍の身なして、天入道の無知の友柄に同じゅうして、知者の振る舞いをせずして、ただ一向に念仏すべし。そう、ただ一向に念仏すべし。念仏阿弥陀仏、南無阿弥陀仏。And as for, that is,All as for the birth in 念仏 as, no, no, as for the birth in the pure land of Amida Buddha. That is all for birth in the pure land. Why? Because after going to the pure land, he wants to save many people who are getting suffering, who are getting sickness, those kind of suffering, you know, in this life. He wants to save. That isFor others, everything he does is for others, is behind 法然上人 mind. So, next words is 賞のために良心を持ってす。 And this is actually that the proof that this is the 念仏すべし is a conclusion. And the next words 賞のために良心を持ってす is 賞のために means in order to prove. Okay? In order to prove this is authentic, the teaching.What I really wanted to say. And 賞のために is proof. In order to use proof. 両朱印。両 means both. Both. And 朱印 means hand,、handprint. Handprint. So 両朱印を持ってす。Okay. In order for the proof, I here present my handprint. And that follows. And 浄土宗。浄土宗の安心企業をこの石にしごくせり。浄土宗の安心企業をこの石にしごくせり。しごくせり。So, the sentence, the subject and verb in the ending. So, しごくせり means ultimately lead. Ultimately lead is the meaning of しごくせり. So,